Wassaw. This is the last video in the intermediate section, and today we're doing DPC. DPC stands for Desktop Personal Computer, which is used after doing a 8-line PC opener so that you can loop back to your 8-line PC opener again. The sequence would therefore be 8-line PC, DPC, 8-line PC, DPC, 8-line PC, and so on for eternity. DPC is useful in Versus Tetris and also in Blitz and Ultra. This is how it works. Depending on what 8-line PC opener you use, that determines what DPC setups you have to learn. The most popular ways to get an 8-line PC are 2 4-line PCs, SDPC, or MS2. In order of difficulty to learn, from easiest to hardest, it would be MS2, SDPC, and then double 4-line PCs. And learning the first and second PC is hardest by a long margin, and I mean a really, really, really long margin. But the benefit is that you can perform the loop no matter what queue you have. This video is going to teach you how to learn DPC off of 4.lol, because from my own experience, some vague terminologies on the page confuse the hell out of me. As you can see, there are various DPC openers that you have to learn to get 100% DPC knowledge, but depending on the opener that you use, you can actually skip a lot of them. And just note that it says only extra S here, but extra S also counts for extra S and extra Z. Same thing with extra J, that's also extra L. Here I have a table of all the DPCs you have to learn according to the opener. With MS2, you only have to learn extra O, extra S, and extra Z. For SDPC, you only have to learn extra O, extra S/Z, extra T and extra I for 100% SDPC DPC. And if you want to learn first and second PC, you have to know extra O, extra S and Z, extra I, extra J and L, and extra T if you want to learn 100% DPC. The one in brackets are just the edge cases, so most of the time you won't need them. So here's how you'd learn it. First, you'd do your 8-line PC. And once doing that, pay attention to this hold piece. This piece is going to tell you what DPC you need to do. So if we got an S piece, we need to look to the S piece DPC. Now to figure out which one of these you need to do, you need to look at your queue and focus on the O and the S piece. So I got the S piece and the O piece, and I just got to figure out what order they're in. So do I get the S piece first or do I get the O piece first? In this case, I get the S piece first, so I want to look at this. Now I'd make this opener and then use the solutions to try and find it. And in this case, I would have this solution. So another example. So in this case, I see my hold piece. It's a T piece, which means I have to look at the T DPCs. I would make this setup. And then I'd try to find the perfect clear. Finally, last example. After doing my 8-line PC, I have an S piece DPC, and I have to figure out, do I have the O or the S piece first in my queue? In this case, it's the O piece that's first, so I'm gonna go to the O first DPC, and I'm going to copy this opener here, and then try to find the perfect clear. And that's that. Hopefully this helps. All you need to do now is go through these and try practicing them. There should be a lot of maps and user modes on gestures as well, so use them well. Anyway, good luck.